Well, what a depressing start to the week. With the breaking news of England going back into lockdown and the death of Scottish acting icon and independent supporter Sean Connery. The Prime Minister's statement to Parliament exposed for all to see the reality of the unequal union.
The Prime Minister only acted when England needed support.
Those broad shoulders and pooling of resources certainly haven't shaped up to be what we were promised in 2014.
Scottish, Welsh and Northern Ireland taxpayers pool their tax resources to the Treasury. But when it comes to sharing, it seems that only English taxpayers benefit from flexibility.
However, the public can see it for what it is, and it is boosting the nationalist cause.
He may not have noticed yet, but the Prime Minister and his Chancellor are fronting a membership drive for the independence movement.
I voted against the Overeas Operations Bill. The Tory proposal risks exposing armed forces to the International Criminal Court. The Scottish Attitude Study was published, highlighting, amongst other things, the fundamental shift in support for Scottish independence. And Civic Scotland is speaking out against the government's proposals. Last week we had the General Teaching Council, and this week the combined Scottish churches.
The leaders of Scottish Episcopal Church, Church of Scotland, Roman Catholic Church in Scotland, United Reformed Church Scotland, Methodist Church Scotland and Quakers in Scotland are united in their concern at the UK government's actions on Brexit, with its plan to break international law, acting on devolved matters against the wishes of devolved administrations and placing the peace of Northern Ireland in peril.
Gavin Newlands MP presented his fire and rehire bill, which I'm delighted to be supporting. It would give vital protections for workers' rights. I voted against the government's rejection of the Lords' amendments on the agriculture and the immigration bills. I believe it's vital we protect food standards and support family unity in child refugees. My business question this week on foster carers' employment rights highlighted the dilemma of disjointed policy making, with some powers being devolved and others reserved.
While foster care is a devolved matter, employment law isn't. And foster carers don't set their own working hours or rates of pay, cannot subcontract their work. They're highly supervised with regular performance reviews and training, and they're limited to working exclusively for one local authority or an agency at a time. It's clearly employment in all bar name.
It's another example of why we need the full powers of independence. Furlough being extended until March is, in my opinion, a step in the right direction. I also welcome the extension of the self-employed income support scheme for people who are eligible. Although it remains poorly targeted, it offers no relief for those who have become self-employed more recently. The scheme needs extended further to cover self-employed people who have so far been excluded. We have now had 12 opinion polls in a row showing a lead for independence. It really is the settled will of the Scottish people, but we must never be complacent, and we need to keep making the case for independence. Do get in touch if you wish to speak to me at my weekly Friday online surgery. Other appointments are also available on request. And another bit of good news as we end the week is that Scotland has developed a federated server, so that the Protect Scotland app will now work with other UK and Crown dependency apps. That means it now works in England if you must travel to England or Wales.